12 o'clock on a Wednesday, and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
I'm Craig.
And on this week's show...
On this week's show, we've got an off-the-sticks special. Pretty much every single thing we're actually reviewing, we're demming, and not a single card trick in sight.
Well, there kind of is a card trick,
no, not really.
Because I went on a tour this week of the United States Playing Card Company.
You went on a tour of...
Yeah, I flew over.
I've heard they're a big fan of David Penn.
And they invited me over for the VIP tour, and they give you free gifts. And these are these... John, do you want to get it off the sticks? Because they've got these... kind of like card box templates.
Isn't
they
that give,
that's the word.
That's
I'm looking for.
I'm driving that patter out.
I'm
all right, it's John. You might want to stay head on and not too close.
And I thought it'd be really good if you could suddenly imagine that that actually prints.
Wow.
Like that. But there's still a lot of work to do because the inside is not printed just yet. But if I assemble it like a box... You can't hear anything, but if you use your imagination a little bit more...
I hear something.
All of a sudden, a deck of cards materializes. And that's David Regal's Sudden Deck 3.0.
Yeah, it's the third, it's the third version of Sudden Deck, and I've actually owned the first two.
I'll just leave that there.
Try not
probably a Wizard product review logo probably appeared on the screen at that point.
Try not to expose the gimmick. I've owned the first two Sudden Decks. The first one didn't have the printing. You just bought out some. You just had it sort of already printed, and you just closed it up, and you had a deck appear. And the second one,
that was
he added
deck,
the printing.
Yeah.
So yeah, Sudden Deck 2, he added the printing. Now in Sudden Deck 3. The only major difference that I can see is once you've printed it, you can actually show both sides and you've got that very nice display.
You kind of got that move where you go, you know, the inside, there's a lot of work left to do, is what David says, the patter, and then he flicks it around and you produce the deck.
You know what? It's a fact. I've seen a lot of, I've been to a lot of magic competitions.
Yeah.
I've seen people use this as the opening to their magic competition.
Yeah.
Because in a magic competition situation, it's the perfect trick. It's a wonderful opener when you think about it. You know, in about a 20-second period, you're showing, you know, just this, and then it prints, and then a deck appears. It's a great opening. The problem with it is it is incredibly angly.
This was the thought process I went through. I saw it, and I thought, great for invisible deck in front of an audience because they're using their... Mm-hmm. Imagination, you know, your imagination is going to print the card box and then use your imagination, a deck of cards is going to appear. But I asked you, all the time you've been imagining one card, you know, one card, and there's one card face down, your imagination's
nice.
You know, all the usual gumph that you come out with when you're doing cabaret and trying to get an extra 5 minutes out of something this big.
Yeah.
And I thought, do you know what? I'd work on a routine and I'd use it. And because the situation changes so often in a working environment, sometimes you're at a bar mitzvah and, you know, there's nobody in front and everyone's over there and down there and behind you.
Yeah.
And they say, you know, can you do it in another room? And, you know, all kind of stuff like that. The angles are quite crucial. And the viewing angle is kind of like this.
It really is.
Beyond 45 degrees, the way the gimmick is set up at the moment, I don't know how to say it without exposing anything, but it doesn't kind of connect for me.
No.
You know. And it kind of gets exposed slightly.
Here's my thoughts on it, and this is going to surprise you.
Dead on. Brilliant.
This my thoughts on this, and this is going
to
surprise
you. But I would still do a bit to improve it, I think.
Yeah, well, we discussed this before we started filming it. And I said to you that for a parlour show, it would be perfect for a small parlour show. I still think that. But the problem is, you know, with this effect, you've got the printing.
Yeah.
And then you've got the display. I don't think the printing really adds anything. I think the thing that the spectators are going to remember is the production of the deck.
Yeah.
With that in mind, I think that Marcus Eddy's Empty is better than this on so many levels.
It's good. I like it. I do like it. But it's still angly.
It is, but nowhere near as angly.
No, you could do that at a table.
You could do that as a table, and I have done it as a table.
Because the angle with empty It's kind of like, you're all right like this.
Yeah.
The angle is like this.
Yeah. And, so as long as you're staying on a parallel level to the audience so if everyone's sitting down and you just aim it to eye level, you're absolutely fine. And I've done it in a corporate situation.
But hard to see. And some people say the moves are a bit unnatural for mm-hmm. a larger group, whereas sudden deck for a larger group would play better.
But the angles are more of an issue.
Yeah.
I mean, the main difference is obviously you don't have the printing effect with empty. Yeah. You know, it just depends on what you want. I can't see many people using this unless they're professional magicians that want to do it.
That understand their their conditions.
And are able to control the environment accordingly. If you're an amateur and you're looking for a trick to do down the pub to your mates, I don't think this is going to work for you. I'd recommend getting Marcus Eddie's empty. But for the person, you know, for the professional performer that knows a place that they want to use this, if you've got Sudden Deck 2 and you like Sudden Deck 2, go for Sudden Deck 3, because there's no difference other than you've got that beautiful display of both sides of the card box before you produce the deck. I don't think it's going to work for many people.
If you like the effect,
mm-hmm.
and you're not worried about angles, go for it. I'm worried about it, which is why I'm only giving it 74%.
I'm exactly the same. I can't think of many places where I'm going to use this. If I was entering a magic competition,
it looks good,
yeah,
but in perfect conditions.
I prefer Marcus Eddie's empty. I can't give it more than 70%. As an effect, it's amazing. The limitations on it mean that I have to mark it down.
Yeah, that's fair. Right, you ready for a miracle? A miracle. Ready, John? I showed you this.
I'm not convinced. Of course, I see a piece
awesome.
Of look, it's a piece of plastic. It's not a miracle.
Not just any piece.
No, that is blue crystal. John, go and get a close look at this. Blue crystal. Here we go. Now, Craig, you've got to be careful.
Yeah.
You can't touch this because it's kind of like radioactive and that. You know.
Really.
Radioactive stuff and and that.
Right.
Yeah?
Okay.
But you can. Can tap that, but don't touch that with your bare hand, seriously. Just tap it.
Let me tap it with my finger.
Right, you tap it with your finger, but do not keep contact for more than 2 seconds because it's radioactive.
Okay.
That's it. Now, I've also got this playing card. Now, I could use a normal playing card, but the thing is, if I dipped a normal playing card into the radioactive solid material, it would dematerialize.
Nice justification.
Yeah, it would. It's encased in plastic.
Okay.
Now, John, you get as close as you like, mate. As close as you like. So what I'm going to do, I've got to be careful how I do this. I can't put it in too quickly. I've got to dip that in there. Like that. There we go.
What?
It's going straight. Can you see that, John? It's actually dipped that right in the plastic. Sorry, the blue crystal. The blue crystal, sorry. And it's coming out again. It's coming out. Right, you ready? And it's actually out. And now, Craig, look. Just tap that.
That's solid.
Solid plastic.
That is
but
solid.
But we can do better than that. Right, you ready?
Yeah.
John, get really close. I want you to zoom in on this coin. Right, get this coin full screen, look. Now, just in case it leaks, I'm going to put that right over the top. Go really close. We've even got the red light for the camera reflecting in there, which is really cool. But, look, can you see that, John? Look, stay really close. Can you see it? Zoom right in. Zoom right in on that coin. Look, it's actually starting to stay right on the coin. Right on the coin. And that's it, it's going, starting to zoom. That's it, it's going straight down. It's actually dipping. Can you see it dipping?
What?
And it's lowered right down. And have a look at it from the side, John. It's like lowered into there.
It is.
Can you see that? Now I'm just going to concentrate. And the coin is going to rise very slowly. It's going through the plastic. You see it actually rising right now? It's actually rising right to the top. And once again, there we go. Look at that. Check that out. Look.
What?
Solid. Look at that. Miracle! John, what do you think to that?
It's a miracle.
I don't know how that came across on the video. But that is just weird. Like, that is solid. And the coin just sunk down. The card dipped into it. That card did go down into that plastic. That looked.
That is not plastic, Craig.
It's blue crystal.
Right.
That is a rare,
okay.
Rare.
That's what that says.
Do you remember a couple of weeks ago? I said that I didn't like Hole because it looked like a toy.
Yes.
Compared to this, Hole looks...
It's organic.
It's the most organic.
We have to say it's organic.
Yes, it's organic. Hole organic. Is the most organic.
Somebody's having a drink somewhere now.
We've got a new drinking game, haven't we?
Yeah, organic.
Organic. That is just the most toyish... Well, it's Tenyo, so of course it is. But it is the biggest toy looking thing ever. Are you telling me, Dave, that you're going to go out into a working gig and you're going to just go up to a table and you're going to go, hello, let me bring out my radioactive blue crystal that looks a little bit like a lump of plastic, and while we're at it, let me bring out my...
Blue crystal. You just don't understand. You don't understand what's commercial these days.
No, I don't. If that's commercial, then I obviously need to quit magic right now, because that... I tell you where it's this is great for... Right. I'm fooled. I have no idea how it works, and I'll tell you something right now. I would buy this. I would have it at home. I'd stick it on my coffee table, and when people come round, I'd say, oh, you got to look at this. This is really cool. But there's no way... ever, not even for a kid's gig, that I would take this out.
Not for a kid's gig. Not even residency.
Oh, yeah.
Kids would love that.
No, no. I am not going to damage my reputation by bringing out that piece of plastic.
It's not plastic, right?
It's plastic.
Blue crystal.
It's plastic.
It's blue crystal.
Okay. I'm not going to ever do the blue crystal in the real world.
I'll let you mark it. I'm giving that miracle status, but I'll let you...
Can I look at my judging criteria? What's our judging criteria? Okay. Okay, good enough to go into my... Dave's working set. No, it's not going into your working set. It's not going into my working set. 50 to 70%, it's getting there, but for it's flawed for reasons. Yeah, okay, I'll go with that. It's 60%. I'm giving it 60%. It's a very good trick. I'm fooled. I've got no idea how it works, but it's never going to be worked. If you want to get something to do at home, fine. It's amazing. Don't get me wrong, it's amazing, but I can't see anybody actually going out and working it. What are you giving it?
Well, I don't think it's fair. I think it's a miracle.
You're giving it miracle status?
Yeah. So congratulations to John Penman that correctly identified Tag Tom Wright.
Well done, John.
On the trailer for One, even before it was...
Now,
launched.
You spun it last time. I'm going to give it such a welly.
Right, this is right. What you're aiming for. Round here, next to the TA box.
John,
the TA box set.
I'm going to get you a TA box set. Watch this. Here we go.
Right.
One giant spin.
Also get the highest rated product of this week.
You get the highest rated product of this week.
And, oh, it was nearly a chill by Tag Tom Wright, which could have been very funny, which is a fantastic haunted deck in the hands of the spectator. But you're going to get from Jeff Brace a copy of Fuse, and you get the highest rated product of this week as well. So watch the rest of the show, see what gets the highest rating.
Well done, John.
Might be a toy.
So next up, I've got my own toy. When I came into the unit today, John handed me my own toy trick.
Oh, it's Christmas.
I know it is. And I've learnt it, and it's better than your trick. It's better than your toy trick, because it looks less toy-y.
We'll see.
I know it is, and it's more impressive trick.
Blue crystal's going to take some beating.
No, this is something Japanese. Number 8.
Tenyo number 8.
Tenyo number 8. I think it's Crystal Cleaver. Magic Entertainment, I don't know, but we're going to get off the sticks. John, can you get off the sticks for me? Now, I'm going to let you examine everything, because I wasn't allowed to examine your thing. I was just allowed to tap on it.
No, because it's...
Everything.
Scientific experiment.
Gets examined. Now, the first thing is, there's this base. Check the base out for me.
Yep, bevel base.
Bevel base.
I like it.
Nice. Next thing you got is this. This is a crystal. Now, this is crystal.
Yeah.
Your thing was plastic. This is crystal. You can check it
plastic.
Out. Genuine.
Plastic. Isn't it?
Genuine crystal.
Yeah.
And notice the lid opens and closes. It hinges at the front. And
recess thingy.
And there's no holes in the sides of the box with things going down to them.
Yeah, I can
very
see
important.
That.
Yeah. The other thing that you've got is this. Now, this is plastic. Purple plastic. but everything happens inside the cover of darkness. So it's important that you realise that...
No purple art or anything like that.
No purple art. And then finally, you've got a sword very similar to the one you've got in your promo picture.
Oh, yeah, on Facebook. That'll work. Yeah.
Do that, yeah.
Yeah, that'll do.
Looking good. And finally, you've got a ring. Now, according to the instructions, you're meant to borrow a ring.
Yeah.
I did try and borrow John Farr's ring, but he wouldn't let me.
No, he never takes it off. Since, at a gig, you're doing the illusion show, weren't you, John? And you kept catching it. He said, oh, I'll take it off, put it in my pocket. And he got home that night.
Right.
And he never heard the end of it all week. Marie was like, why did you take your ring off? And he's like, honestly. And she went, John, just go back to work.
Is that true, John?
No.
Yes, it is. I can
yes,
tell.
It is. Carry on.
Okay, anyway. So we got a ring.
You never wear a ring, do you?
Well, I told Sarah that because I do a lot of coin magic in gigs.
Oh, there you go, John.
And she said that I don't have to wear a wedding ring. I don't even own one.
And what about that night you had the other night with Miss Walsall?
Oh, she was amazing. Like, Miss Teen Wolf.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Wow. Anyway, Sarah's pregnant at home, so who cares?
Love you, darling. So anyway, we've got...
You're going to live that down.
I don't think I'm going to.
I'll not be coming round for a while. Sarah.
I'll be. I think I'll be sleeping down in the office for a few days.
Lama's staying at Matthew's. Right.
Check the ring out. It's a ring that comes with it, and it is perfectly okay.
Yes.
Yes. Now here we go.
It is a normal ring.
It is a normal
ring. You
could
borrow
it. You could borrow it. Yeah. I did this to James Atkinson's mom. He came into the unit today, and I did it to James.
To her ring.
To her ring.
Yeah.
And she was blown away.
Okay.
Now the ring goes here inside, and once it's inside, you'd agree that there's no way that it can come out.
No.
Yeah,
because
is that fair?
It's in the little stand.
Yeah, exactly.
Inside. Yeah.
So that goes here on the base, and then this goes on top. And the idea of this is it covers it up. But before I do, I want you to see that it's twice the size of the actual
twice as tall.
Yes, yeah. Very important.
That's fair.
Now put your finger down on top, so there's no way that I can manipulate anything.
Okay.
Okay. Now the sword goes through the sides of the box like this.
Okay.
So it's currently hovering above the crystal box.
Yeah.
Now I'm going to come over here, and John, I want you to watch this. I'm going to go down. Now, right now, what's happening is I'm hitting the top of the crystal box.
Yeah.
Okay? I can actually feel it there. It's actually right there. Now, I'm going to try and push and penetrate through the box. There you go.
I love the acting.
Now, I'm going to go one step further. I'm actually going to go through the ring, the borrowed ring. Just like this. You'll hear it go through. Listen. Just
yeah.
like that.
I heard that.
Now, I don't want to touch anything. I want you to lift up the cover.
Going for it.
And you'll see that it's actually gone right through the box. Now lift up the box, lift up the lid of the box, and you can actually see that the sword has penetrated right through. Lift up the lid of the box, and then take out the sword, keeping the ring on there. And Dave, it's actually penetrated right through your ring, and everything is instantly examinable as it was at the beginning.
That is a good trick, isn't it?
Isn't that amazing?
That is actually quite a good trick.
And you know what? The reason I think this is more commercial is because the only important thing that you need here is this and this. The cover can be anything. It can't. As long as you, what I mean is you can go and get yourself a cover made that
can
looks
you?
Like this. I reckon you could go and get yourself a nice wood. If you went to,
I don't think you
if
can.
If you went to a carpenter
I don't
and
think
said,
you can.
I reckon you can make a wooden cover
no.
or a brass cover.
No, you can't.
You can't.
Me, you can't.
I'm sure you could.
Me, you can't. Stop the film just for a second. Can it, Craig?
No. No, it can't, Dave. No. 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 No, it can't.
It has to be this colour.
Okay, let me rephrase. You could paint this.
You could paint it.
You could paint it so it doesn't look so plasticky.
If you wanted to,
if you wanted to. The point is, I want to try this out.
This all looks all right.
Yeah.
You can even get, like, little knives and, like,
yeah.
you know, when you're on holiday in like, Egypt and
yeah.
places like that, you get all stuff like this in souvenir shops.
I want to think that it would be a good lead-in to a ring and string routine or a ring on stick routine. I think it'd be a good
it
lead-in.
It is like a mini illusion. It is very nice. I remember this coming out years and years ago, and it fooled me badly, and there's no, you know... It is good. It's an amazing trick.
It's amazing. And
this looks okay. This looks okay. This looks okay. Like you say, if you painted this with a nice texture, like I was playing around with sand-coloured paint.
Yeah.
I was trying to spray some eggs at one point, but it was like a sandy-coloured paint. Or you can get wood paint these days that as you put it on, it looks like wood.
You could
I think if you did that and varnished it, everything would look nice.
You
but
could,
the fact that you've got this stupid... Like iron black, like it looks
just,
like a toy.
It looks terrible.
Everything else is great.
That looks good. That looks like a toy. You could even use you were talking about a toothpick being used.
I don't think you can because I thought about that again and I don't think it would go
through
there.
No. It has to be the same props.
It has to be a thin thing that
you
goes
could
straight.
Present it as a mini illusion.
A nail file.
You could present
with
it
with a nail file.
Yeah, why not? You could present it as a mini illusion. I like that idea.
The concept that it is genius. My only problem with this is why it's not getting above 90% is because you wouldn't use it in its current form because of this. You'd have to do a lot more to it. All these props
I do
look
think,
okay.
Yeah, I do think it looks better than that. And
yes.
it's examinable.
Yeah, okay.
And that one, now you've explained to me how it works, that's not really examinable.
No. It's it's a good trick.
Yeah.
The props look like a toy, though. But, you know, it's not terrible. No. It's not terrible.
It is more organic because it's a borrowed ring, and yeah. I do think that I would give it
66%.
Okay.
I'm giving it 66.
Okay.
Because I think that's... I really like it. I'm kind of... I think it's because it's a trick I saw when I was younger as well, and it fooled me badly. And, you know, I really wanted it when I was a kid as well. I think it's a great trick.
You know
trick.
What? We talked earlier about that and not doing it for kids, and I said I wouldn't do that in a residency. Yeah. I might do that in a residency with a borrowed a polo. You know, actually borrow a polo from a kid. It'd fit in there,
it might
I think,
fit, actually.
And
yeah.
actually do it with a borrowed
polo.
Good
idea, actually.
And then go into that thing where you pull it through your leg.
Yeah, and then make them all sick in the yeah, harvest
totally.
For dinner. That'd be great.
You know what? I got to give it more than the other thing. I don't know if it's going to go into my working set. I'd like to believe it is. You know, I might throw it in my close-up case if there's space and then, like, try
your close-up
it out
case,
and,
seriously.
Yeah, my
carry
magic
on.
Close-up case. I'm going to give it 75%. It's good. There are limitations, but think about it. It's angle proof. It's examinable.
I just wish that looked wooden.
Yeah, me
or
too.
Or even just black or something.
Me too. Still very good.
Good trick. So it's special guest time. An important announcement, so we don't get to do it.
No. Whenever there's an important announcement on the Wizard Product Review, it's always handled by
Mr. John Farr. There he is. Nice of him to dress up.
I've had a few people emailing, why do we call you Lego Hair Far? That would
go.
Be the reason.
Yeah. Start my hair like this way.
Yeah.
It was at a gig we did that.
Important sort of like... announcement.
Yes. We've launched a brand new website.
There you go.
Basically.
Job done.
That's it. Thanks, John.
The website is faster. It offers downloads. It's a fully searchable site. And the key thing is, a lot of people asked for is that the Wizard Product Review was fully searchable.
You know what I've had so many people say to me? How do I find the latest episode? I don't subscribe on YouTube. Well, first of all, you should. But
yep.
Second of all, now on the new website,
yep.
If they type, and this is just awesome, if they type in a product.
Panic, something like that.
Panic
yep.
or whatever. It will instantly come up with the description of the effects,
yep.
the price.
Yeah.
And as well as all that, it'll link you straight through to the show that it was reviewed on.
Correct.
So you can have a look at the review.
Correct.
And John, I looked on our Facebook page last week. You put like a post on saying a new show was coming.
Yeah, what's all this about? Like, what's all this about?
Does it have something to do with why you and Mark were painting that studio on the other side green?
Yeah, a little bit.
Two questions.
Yeah.
One, why weren't me and Dave consulted on this? And two, how come we don't get green screen?
It's my show.
You get special effects for John's show.
You
so what is the show? What
you
is
get
the show?
Special effects and we get a white fluffy dog.
What's the show?
The show is, it's world. It's a chart show, basically, of the world's greatest magic.
Okay.
The best-selling product magic.
And how's the chart worked out?
It's worked out. We speak to different distributors and collect all the sort of numbers of the sales, and they get ranked in the top 10.
And how often is this coming
sales
out?
Sales at World Magic Shop as well, yeah.
And sales at World Magic Shop, yeah. It comes out on the last Sunday of every month, similar to chart shows, basically.
So you've brought one out, and it's Maze, isn't it?
It is, yes.
And I've seen it. It's the very first one. It's nearly as good as our first ever Wizard Product Review.
Oh, it's so much better. Like,
it's
if you've
nearly,
ever seen
nearly.
It, if you want to laugh, go back and watch the first Wizard Product Review. Hello, my name's Craig Pesson. My name's David
there.
Penn.
And because it's a new site, we've got like a little free giveaway, haven't we, as well?
Oh, yeah.
Now, all their details, are they on the site already if they're an existing customer?
All their details will be on there. The only thing, it's a brand new shopping cart, basically. There's going to be a wish list added and all that kind of jazz. What you have to do is reset your password. Because of the data encryption that we use on the current site, we couldn't export that. So that's what you would need to do. It's a very simple process.
No problem. But then you've got access to a whole bunch of stuff.
Yeah.
Including free downloads.
And let's talk about this download that they're going to get for free immediately.
Yeah, immediately. It probably will be chargeable eventually, but for the time being, absolutely free. We've got an effect by a guy called Brian O'Neill, and literally with English lottery tickets. And
Or American, I think it probably
Yeah, or American, because there's a PDF that comes with it as well.
Yeah.
But Brian gave us very kind permission to include on the download his PDF and his method for performing an incredible mind-reading effect with lottery tickets.
Literally, they
think of your lucky number on the lottery ticket.
Yeah.
You don't have to look at them. They leave them face down. Regular English lottery tickets.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing special about them at all, and you know the number they're thinking of.
You know what? I just want to say a personal thank you for Brian for allowing us to offer this to everybody completely free of charge. Yeah. Now, he's got some amazing ebooks. I've been reading through them.
Yeah.
He's got some great material. please, if you like this, when you've looked at it, check out his ebooks because he's got some
amazing. In the description, we'll put a link to Brian's site as well.
Yeah.
So have a look at his other stuff. But he's given this free because he watches the Wizard product review and he gave this free for the launch of the new site, which is absolutely fantastic.
Really, seriously, thank you, Brian.
And anything else, John?
That's it.
That's it. Nothing else special. Are we getting a new coffee machine or anything?
No coffee machine.
That's it.
New website, new show.
Anything for us?
Do we get stuff?
Can we have another shoe show? I'll give you a new bin bag.
You get a bin bag?
Yeah.
So we can keep the
office. I think that's a hint.
Yeah.
So finally on the show, we've got Not So Sharp by Wayne Fox.
Not So Sharp by Wayne Fox.
You've been playing with this, haven't you? You call these toys, but you've been like, oh, let me play with those.
Oh, man. I saw this. I opened it up.
Toys
I saw the props. And I immediately thought, there are so many things you can do with this. The idea is...
What does he do with it first? Yeah.
Right, well, let me just read the back for you. The audience will be astounded as you take a Sharpie pen and suddenly roll it into a ball and then immediately flatten it before you stretch it all the way back out again. Not Sharp is the perfect addition to any signed card routine. Contains two gimmicks and a DVD.
Yeah.
Now, these are your two gimmicks. You have a flattened Sharpie and you have a rolled up Sharpie. The idea is that...
And they're kind of made like of... like, not rubber... In fact, it's a bit harder than
rubber,
but they kind of got a little bit of ply on them.
Yeah.
But they're not, they're hard. They're not, the ball doesn't bounce,
does
it? No,
the ball does not bounce.
But Wayne says on the video, you know, be careful with it. Don't try and bounce it because it might chip or something.
Yeah, and you don't want that to happen.
It's not a bouncy ball.
I absolutely love it. Wayne goes through various ways of basically making it look like you're rolling up a Sharpie, making it look like you've flattened a Sharpie. He goes through various techniques. He goes through palming. He goes through doing
I like the one where it's on the table. No, he's got the pen and he kind of goes straight down.
That looks really good.
And, you know, you need a bit of setup to it.
Yeah.
But, you know, it is really visual.
Looks amazing. And that uses a, you know...
One of those gimmicks that you use to get women.
Yeah, there you go. It uses one of those.
Yeah.
But I've been playing around with it, and, you know, even if you don't use that, and even if you don't use your sleeves, you can do some amazingly visual stuff. As long as you know a flipstick move and you know some basic sleight of hand, you can do some amazing stuff with it. And what's great about this, it's one of those things that you just want to play around with. If you've seen my DVD Chop, you know that I've got a routine on there, a bonus routine called Sharp.
I think he's mentioned Chop. Two episodes this month.
Yeah, probably. Yeah, I'm trying to go for a hat trick
again.
But what I have a routine called Sharp where I basically mess around with a Sharpie before I go into Chop. This is perfect. This is absolutely perfect. You could use this gimmick.
He has been playing with this all morning, like no exaggeration.
Wayne, if you're watching the show, I think this is brilliant. I think this is to Sharpies. Well, and this is the highest praise that I can give it. This Not So Sharp is to a Sharpie pen what the Omnidek is to a pack of cards.
Well,
if you are a worker and you carry a Sharpie around with you, there is no reason why you should not have this. Because the moment that you take the pen and roll it up and then give it to them, stop your act right there. It's like producing a jumbo coin at the end of a coin routine. You know, you just got nowhere else
I've
to go.
I've got a thing in my lecture... where I have the black eight,
yeah,
and I go like that, and the eight ball changes back.
Yes,
you could have the Sharpie there if it's on the Top It DVD as well, where you've got the Sharpie,
yeah,
and you could literally go like that,
yeah,
and slap it and just put that into your top pocket.
That looked great. Yeah.
And using an idea of Mark Southworth's, mm-hmm. which was an eight ball turning to a flat eight ball, using the same move from the Top It DVD as well, and then immediately putting it in this top pocket, which
he
actually
mentions Top It's as part. It's a very good DVD.
That's right, he does.
He mentions it, but it doesn't go into your technique.
He says about using a waistcoat Top It, doesn't
he?
But yeah, that technique of there showing the pen there and then going like that and then straight into the top pocket would work, I do believe. And I want this as well. It's great.
This is
a worker.
It's worker. It's got to get worker of the week.
Worker of the week.
Every single worker is going to have one of these. I guarantee you, this is going to become the effect that every single worker carries around with them, because it's great. You're getting someone to sign a card, you take the pen back, boom, you're putting more magical
moments. Fun to practice as well.
Oh, it really is. It's just great.
And
I'm going to do this. This is going straight into my, not just, this is going into my close-up case, it's going into my pockets, it's going everywhere. I'm carrying this around with me all the time.
It's going in your close-up case.
It's going in my close-up
Something
case.
Else in the close-up
yeah,
case.
Yeah, of course it's going into my close-up case. I'm going to have to give this 96%. I think this is genius. I think that everybody's going to want to do this.
I think I'm going to try it, and I do love it. It's definitely getting Worker of the Week. I'm giving it 90%. John, Worker cool. Special?
Yeah, I think so. Let's give it an instant card chart. In fact, let's just give everything a Worker Special this week.
Really?
Well, they're not all they're not all workers, so. No.
Well, let's just give away a free product with every order off the Wizard Product Review.
You feeling all right?
So if they order Not So Sharp, the Crystal Cleaver, Blue Crystal, or Sudden Deck 3, if they order those, they'll get what you've got there in your hand.
Card What's that? Yeah.
So by 12 midnight on Friday, they'll get Alan Bursky's Instant Card Sharp, the best damn gambling demonstration you can learn in 10 minutes flat.
It is actually very good. I've read that book.
Just add cards. Decent, yeah. It's very good. Divine Goddess 23 Productions. Buy this routine, Mac King. Well, you don't have to buy it, you get it free.
There you go. Fantastic. Matt King gives you a quote.
And there's also a quote from Jim Steinmeier on the front as well. So I might just be taking that home and having a look at that. I know you've got to go.
Yeah, I've really got a gig to go to. So I'm going to take my Look Sharp gimmicks and I'm going to grab my close-up case. I will see you guys next week on the Wizard Product Review. Bye. I'm Craig.
I'm Dave. See you next week.
See you later. Yeah, I'm going to be there in about half an hour. I was just doing the Wizard Product Review with Penn. Yeah. It's all good. What? The third floor? Are you serious? Is there a lift? There's no lift?
No. Just there. That's it.